Within Katmai National Park and Preserve in Alaska is a strange geologic oddity. There, 14 miles north-northeast of the active Grieg stratovolcano, is a circular depression in the ground. Known as Savonoski Crater, it measures 1,738 feet or 530 meters wide, and from its rim to the water surface in the crater lake is 164 feet or 50 meters. Looking at this feature, you might think, wow, this is a fascinating impact crater, albeit a fairly small one. And, for many years, this feature was thought to be an impact crater. However, more than 50 years after its discovery, we are no closer to discovering the true origin of this circular structure than we were in the 1970s. The main problem revolves around the following issue. Most impact craters exposed on Earth's surface that happen to have formed in the last 5 million years show a notable feature. That is, they formed in areas that have large surface exposures of sedimentary or metamorphic rock. And, in the rare chance the impact crater formed on top of volcanic rock, the solidified lava, ash, or other magmatic products are generally many millions, if not billions, of years older than the exposed surface of the crater. However, at volcanoes around the planet, there is a type of volcanic vent which looks just like an impact crater. For example, in Oregon, there is the 1 mile wide and 360 foot deep feature simply known as Hole in the Ground. This feature formed during a voluminous explosive eruption when one of the adjacent volcanic complexes produced a magmatic intrusion. As the magma advanced upwards, the heat of the material transferred through the crust, heating ever-present groundwater. Eventually, this water flashed to steam, and since the same mass of steam takes up significantly more volume than the water it once was, it caused an immense amount of pressure to build. After reaching a critical point, a powerful explosive eruption occurred, creating a large explosion crater known as a Maar, which did not erupt any lava. Thus, if a meteorite or small asteroid was to strike a volcanic area around the same time it was erupting or highly active, how would scientists be able to determine its origin? And this is exactly the problem at Savonoski Crater. Although the closest volcano to Savonoski Crater is Mount Griggs, a total of 11 volcanoes are within a 33-mile or 53-kilometer radius, marking it as one of the most volcano-rich areas on the planet. You might be wondering why I chose the seemingly arbitrary number of 33 miles. The answer is that this distance represents the furthest away a vent in an active volcanic complex can be from another vent, at least that I am aware of, excluding true fissure complex volcanoes such as seen in Iceland. Thus, any one of these 11 volcanoes could have theoretically created this crater. This possibility is supported by the fact that 5 small volcanic cones are located in relatively close proximity to Savonoski, which all formed in the last several million years. However, these two ideas are not the only legitimate possibilities to consider. Looking around areas in cold climates from satellite, you might notice an absurdly high number of depressions in the ground which often have lakes and can sometimes be surprisingly circular. These features are known as kettles and formed during the process of glacial retreat. During this process, chunks of the glacier or individual blocks of ice break off and are left behind by the retreating glacier. They are later buried by sediment, and thus, when they finally melt, they leave a depression in the ground. And, if the depression dips below the water table, the kettle fills with water. This is why large sections of Alaska, Canada, Russia, and other areas that used to be covered by numerous glaciers have many thousands of these features. The final possibility revolves around the recent discovery of natural gas explosion craters in the permafrost of Russia. After a pocket of natural gas reaches a certain pressure, it may violently shoot upwards via a path of least resistance, which sometimes forms a crater. However, this possibility seems the least likely of the group, as I could not find any record of nearby natural gas deposits in this section of Alaska. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Jeff Harkness, for supporting this channel.